few days back, Japanese Prime Minister Shinzo Abe announced his resignation citing poor health. He will be dearly missed by our country, as under him, India and Japan's diplomatic relations strengthen so much more. A lot has been said about his tenure, so we thought today we'll talk about his economics. So what is Abenomics and what can India learn from it? When Shinzo Abe stepped in as Prime Minister in 2012, Japan's economy was not doing well at all. Its GDP growth rate had fallen to -4.3%. Demand and exports were less. The country was moving towards recession. So Abe had to act fast and decisively. So Abenomics happened. The plan was to use a detailed growth-oriented progress in which fiscal policy, monetary policy and structural reforms work together towards growth. The Japanese government initially planned an outlay of 10.3 trillion yen in a bid to improve infrastructure and generate more employment opportunities, as this would create demand for steel, vehicles, heavy machinery, etc. In 2014, the government added 5.5 trillion yen to this package. The government worked with the central bank to ensure the free flow of credit and cut interest rate to zero. They even started paying money to people to borrow when they set interest rates at levels below zero and printed new money without being afraid of the rise in inflation, as Japanese have always been huge savers and not spenders. There was a huge shortage of labor, mostly as Japan's population is said to be fast aging and the birth rate had been falling. So the Japanese government spent over 2 trillion yen on childcare and educational reforms to boost birth rates. The government also tried to induct women into the workforce to solve this problem. The unemployment rate dipped to under 3% for the first time in 20 years. The economy witnessed slow and steady growth before the pandemic, of course, although many economists believe that the effect of Abenomics is fading. The important thing is that we can learn from it. We can learn that the Prime Minister Shinzo Abe conceded the problems in the economy publicly and continued to try new things. Although India has also continued to try new things with the economy, those things have been mostly driven by politics and not economics. And admitting that our economy has a problem, that would be our first step.